Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for that introduction. I promise to keep my remarks short because I don't want to get la chancla that they do it at the Oscars. I want to begin, of course, by thanking Janet Murguia and NCLR, all the NCLR affiliates, for the great work that they do day in and day out. Let's give them a round of applause. Like NCLR and its affiliates, the Hispanic Caucus fights to advance Latino priorities every day. And as the numbers and the influence of the Latino community continues to grow in this country, we have to exercise our power. Latinos are the fastest growing demographic in the United States, and by 2050, we will make up 30% of the U.S. population. We are also an incredibly young and vibrant community. The average age of a Latino living in the United States is under the age of 30. Latinos are here to stay, and that has huge implications for the future of this country. Now, whether people choose to accept this idea or not, the success of the United States is intricately tied to the success of the Latino community. Yes, we are a growing community, but we still lag behind in many key areas that hinder our pursuit of the American dream. There are many obstacles in our path, but if I know anything about my community, it's that we are resilient and we are determined. How do I know this? Because that is my family story. I am the daughter of immigrant parents who came to this country without much money and without jobs waiting for them. Still, they managed to raise 7 children who all went on to college and became contributing professionals in their communities. 2 of us, I like to say the underachievers of the family, even became members of the United States Congress. But our story is not unique, because I've heard it repeated thousands of times over and over again in other Latino families. Their parents sacrificed and struggled so that their children's futures wouldn't be limited. Despite the linguistic barriers, the economic hurdles, and the educational disparities, our community continues to progress. But it is not enough for some of us to send our children to college while 35% of Latinos still drop out of high school. We're not doing our youth any justice when we ignore the reality that too many Latinos are struggling academically. When we can't ensure that our youth even has a basic academic foundation, we essentially leave them to fend for themselves. Now, I'm reminded of Father Gregory Boyle's work with rehabilitating gang members in the Los Angeles area. He started Homeboy Bakery as a way to give Latino youth a path to joining the workforce instead of joining the adult prison population. And his motto is, nothing stops a bullet like a job. Education and economics go hand in hand. If youth don't have either opportunity, their chance to succeed in this country becomes no more than a distant hope. Creating more economic opportunities for Latinos is one of the issues that I'm really passionate about. Today, the average Latino household owns just 7 cents for every $1 of wealth held by the typical white household. 7 in 10 Latino families don't have enough savings to cover even 3 months of living expenses. Income inequality in this country is real, and it is a real threat to our nation's economy. Last year, Standard & Poor's, which is not exactly a liberal, publication, issued a report saying that income inequality is one of the largest hindrances to our country's economic growth. Again, smart policies that will help the Latino community are going to be good formulas for helping our country succeed as well. Latino purchasing power generates $1.5 trillion in economic activity every year. Just imagine what that number would be if we were able to pass comprehensive immigration reform and policies like a living wage that help put money back into the hands of Latino families. But that's not going to happen until the representatives in the United States Congress look like the America that they are elected to represent. Comprehensive immigration reform is embraced by a majority of Americans, but it won't become a reality unless we participate in every election. It's true. Providing administrative relief to millions of families is the right thing to do while we work on a legislative solution. But administrative relief is only going to get us so far. The next president of the United States will have to do more than just promise to address the needs of our community. They will have to proactively act to reform the outdated policies that hold our community back. And we, in turn, must be vocal and put our priorities front and center on the agenda. We must not sit idly by and be spectators to our futures, but active participants that engage everyone in our family, from the youngest to the oldest, but most especially our youth. Only when we fully participate will our community be the force that we're destined to be. Thank you to each and every one of you for being tonight and for helping to get us there. We need you, and thank you for the very important role that you play in advocating for our community. Gracias y buenas noches.